The structure of the solar system is interesting. We have the innermost planets, the four that are rocky planets. Mars is a very small planet, relatively speaking. Why is it so small? That's a big question in planetary science. Then Jupiter, big gas giant. Jupiter and Saturn accreted so much that they got really big. And then you have the ice giants, Neptune, Uranus. And then you have the Kuiper Belt with Pluto and other planetary bodies in it that is mostly ice balls, which we've only begun to explore. The asteroid belt between Jupiter and Mars is the source of many of our meteorites. It has a relatively small mass, only about 4% of the mass of the Moon. Most of that mass is in the largest asteroids, and most of the asteroids are relatively small. And there are a couple of theories of why no planets formed in the asteroid belt early on in the solar system's history. One is that Jupiter drifted inward toward Mars and hurled the bodies in the asteroid belt either into the inner planet region or out towards the Kuiper Belt. That left the planetesimals there with too much energy to form a planet. Another theory is that Uranus and Neptune switched places early on in the formation of the solar system. That action would have scattered the bodies in the Kuiper Belt, shooting a battery of rocks and icy planetesimals into the inner solar system and the outer solar system. There are many ideas about how our solar system reached the stable configuration of planets that we see today. Those ideas have to explain the asteroid belt and the icy bodies beyond Neptune. The origin of our solar system is a fascinating and very difficult cosmochemical and astrophysical problem.